is a hot topic that's being discussed in the United States as we speak today. There is a hot topic on CNN. Can you imagine it? CNN are talking about the nursing shortage in the United States. They're trying to find solutions.
Like that?
Yeah.
What?
Can you jiggle these oranges?
Jiggle oranges?
Yeah.
Of course I can jiggle oranges.
What do you mean jiggle oranges? Of course I can jiggle oranges. Is that what you meant?
Yeah, I only want three.
I can jiggle oranges with my eyes closed.
Three.
What, three of them? Of course I can. How you doing? Oh my god, those daily vlogs are driving me crazy! It's all good, you know, I love making those videos for y'all. I love to provide value and insight to the American dream. But these videos are causing me sleep deprivation. I am lucky, and I'm saying lucky, if I sleep at 1 a.m. And every day I've gotta be up by 5:30. You know what happens? I put my alarm at 5:30, I keep snoozing to like 6:05 or 6:10, and then I start racing myself. Alright, you've seen the title. Before jumping into hospital offers, big bonuses, free housing, tuition, and all that, I've got two topics to talk about. First, happy International Women's Day. And I want to take this chance to say to my wife, happy International Women's Day. Women are a big deal in the community out here, and they talk a lot about equality and fair opportunities. And I believe there are a lot of women leaders out there, and here I'm addressing the women. When you come to this country, I want you to think about leadership. I want you to be a leader. Boost that self-confidence. I want you to believe in yourself because you have the same equal opportunities as any woman in the United States. The second point I want to talk about, it is a comment on my previous video. And I'm gonna read it for all of you. It's not because I want to argue, it's just because I feel empathy. I mean, the person who put that comment, he could be a genuine person. He could be someone with great ambition, outstanding skills, and have gigantic dreams. But out of transparency, I just want to give an example that you have to do whatever it takes to make it. You are on your own journey. No one gives a shit about you. It's all you. So make the best out of it and do what works for you. So I'm gonna go ahead and put his comment on the screen and I'm gonna discuss it. So that person is saying that my video was kind of confusing to him because, and this is a clause because he started his comment with if. And there's no if in my videos. I don't like to use the if clause because everything mentioned in my videos are based on my own experience and on facts. So he's saying, if I am placed in Pennsylvania, the monthly rent on average is $1,450 for 3-bedroom and 2-bath. And if they require a 1-month rent with a deposit, will it not come to around $3,000? Well, yes, it does. It doesn't need a genius to do the math. But the question is, first, that's an if. If you have an actual example of where your assignment is, like which hospital, and then the houses and apartments around it rent for an average of $1,450, then we can talk. But usually staffing agencies do market studies on hospitals and see if it is affordable for international nurses to come into the country and give them $24 to $27 per hour and still make it. But staffing agencies will not put you in a place where they will set you up for failure. So now we're not talking about the initial amount of money that you're gonna bring with you to the United States. We're just talking about the cost of living. Can you survive over that pay rate? If you're gonna pay $1,450 every month. That's a whole paycheck. So if you want to consider your car payment, your utilities, your phone, your transportation, your grocery shopping, and other expenses, man, $3,000 a month will not be enough. But if that is the case and the average rent is $1,450, my question is, why the f*** are you renting 3-bedroom and 2-bathroom apartment? I will say it again. No one gives a shit about you. It's your own journey. Live by your own terms. And do whatever the f*** works for you. So if 3-bedroom, 2-bathroom apartment is too much for you to afford, then you need to be thinking about like 3-bedroom, 1-bath. Or maybe 2-bedroom, 1-bath. Or maybe 1-bedroom, 1-bath. Because as I said, you're not coming here to the United States to live fancy. You want to make it and you want to achieve your dreams. So be humble. For cell phones, yes, you can sign up for a plan, use whatever you want to use, and by the end of the month, you will get a bill and you pay it. But, and I believe I was clear, I was talking about the Go phones from AT&T. And these are the cheapest and they work best. Why do you want to live in a situation where you don't know how much the bill is going to be by the end of the month? If you have a prepaid plan, let us say you want to pay $25 to pre-charge your phone with credit, then be it. Don't be fancy, man. Don't be fancy. Utilities. So he said in his comment, it depends on the state and the city. So you should pay a deposit like what you paid for internet. Well, as I said in my comment, Virginia, Wisconsin, North and South Dakota, Nebraska, and Maine, I've got batchmates in all these states. And none of them said that they paid security deposits to get electricity or water. They take your credit card information or your checking account. Period. If you pay the bill, you get electricity. If by the end of the month you do not pay the bills, they will cut off electricity. They don't need more guarantee than that. They don't need security deposit. But if you have evidence that one of the states requires security deposit, I would appreciate it if you would enlighten us in the comment section and tell us about it so that everyone will get prepared for it. Otherwise, if you like to live in the if clause, just keep it to yourself, man. For your car, some dealerships may not cover the cost of tax and title, which you may have to pay out of pocket. Listen, man, I'm talking out of experience, right? I'm an agency nurse, I work with Avant. We get a pre-approved car loan, $25,000. Well, of course, if you exceed the $25,000, you're gonna pay out of pocket. But if you purchase a car for $17,000, first off, the tax is included. That's not negotiable. Title, registration, and gap insurance are all included in the car loan. If you have proof for any other scenario, please share it with us. Anyone who's watching, I know a lot of Avant nurses here in the United States watch my videos. If you experience anything like that out of your pocket for your car deal, please share it with us. Please put it down in the comment section. Let's enlighten everyone. If I'm wrong, I'll admit it. I don't think so. By the way, I don't believe I know everything about everything. But listen, man, I'm kind enough to share my experience with you. I'm kind enough to share with you real examples about credit score, budgeting, loans, credit card, and all that sensitive stuff. By the way, I'm not just talking to you, I'm talking to everyone. If you like these videos and you want to see more and you appreciate the effort I put in to share with you this information, please click that like button. It really means the world to me. It will popularize. It will really help my channel on YouTube and make it more discoverable. People will discover it. I know, we spent a lot of time on that before jumping into our topic, but I thought it is crucial to discuss it. Without further ado, there is a hot topic that's being discussed in the United States as we speak today. There is a hot topic on CNN. Can you imagine it? CNN are talking about the nursing shortage in the United States. They're trying to find solutions and they are offering these crazy hospital offers. Big bonuses, 5-digit bonuses, free housing and tuition to your children. All that just to recruit nurses. So as I told you before, when we discussed contracts at the hospital I work at Carl, they said we'll get $5,000 sign-on bonus and they will give you $2,500 for your BSN. Well, that is amazing, right? But I just knew today, and after I read this article, I went ahead and asked. But if you are a nurse that is hired from another state, that means that you are relocating, or you are hired from a city in the same state, but it is more than 50 miles away. Then you will get a sign-on bonus for $10,000 and you will get relocation fees of another $10,000. Is that awesome? awesome or what? You're freaking right. So in my case, I'm gonna finish my contract with Avant. I'm gonna finish the 2 years and then I'm gonna convert to card employee. I'm gonna get my bonus. I'm gonna get my BSN bonus. And then after I complete my 3 years with Carl, you're damn right, I'm gonna move to another sunshine state, another fancy hospital that offers these crazy bonuses with these crazy benefits, and I'm gonna enjoy my life. Hey man, listen. The United States is a beautiful country. It's beautiful. Every state is way different from another state. It's as if you're traveling to another country, another culture. It is a true privilege for nurses to live in the United States because you will have jobs anywhere, anytime. So why not enjoy your life, enjoy the United States, see as much states as you want. If you move to a state and you didn't like it, finish your contract, do the 3 years and then pick up your shit and move. Okay, so I'm gonna put the link to the article on CNN down in the description box. First link you are going to see in the description box is a link to subscribe to my channel. If you are not subscribed yet, oh my god! Please help a brother out. Click that link down below and subscribe to my channel. The second link is gonna be the link to the CNN article. Check it out. I felt that it gave me a lot of motivation, and for a split of a second, it really made me think about the next chapter of my life. So I'm gonna read one part of this article which I loved, and I bet you guys are gonna love it as well. Apart from the financial aspect, I wanna read this small paragraph for you. So it says, UC Health, which operates 9 acute care hospitals and more than 100 clinics across Colorado, Wyoming, and Nebraska, currently has 330 openings for registered nurses. Since the nonprofit health system can't find all the nurses it needs locally, it has been seeking out candidates from other states and sometimes other countries. That's it, guys. If you like this video, please smash that like button. And if you are new to this channel, please, and I'm saying please, punch that face down below to subscribe. And if you haven't watched yesterday's vlogs, click over there to watch it. Until next time, be an alpha slice.